The preceding program may contain ratchet language, buffoonery, and raw humor, and is intended for mature audiences only. Listener discretion is advised.
System loading. Ready.
They're back.
The reach around
radio.
Clap for a nigga with his rapping ass. Blow a stack for your niggas with your trapping ass. Clap for a nigga with his rapping ass. Blow a stack for your niggas with your trapping ass.
This is your girl, Faith Evans.
Hey, yo, what's up? This your boy, Uncle Luke.
What's up? This is Howard Hewitt.
This is Corrupt Young Gotti.
Yo, this is Terry Crews.
What up? It's your boy, God Tory.
This is Ernest Thomas.
Hey, what's up now? This is your boy, John B.
What's up? This is Anthony Hamilton.
What up, y'all? It's your nigga, Dub C, a.k.a. Skip, the motherfucking Barracuda. You are now Reach Around Radio. Tune the fuck in. Stay tuned in. Turn it up. Yeah.
Yo, you know what? Turn me up in the headphones.
Ooh, check. Can't hear myself.
Yeah, turn me up.
Can't hear myself either. Here we go.
Somebody been fighting in there? What the hell? Come on, these mics.
Wow, really?
Yeah, this is Knockout Station.
It's Reach Around Radio. Don't tell me
Reach
shit.
Reach Around a soccer mother.
It's Reach Around Radio. It's your boy, Speed Doggy Dog, in the house. I want to welcome everybody.
Can I finish?
What?
Lights, cameras. Action.
You want to dim the lights, my man?
Yeah.
Just open the door always. Shit, ain't nobody. What? Anyway, it's Reach Around Radio. It's your boy, Speed Doggy Dog.
Can I say my name?
Yeah,
now?
You can say it.
It's the poetess.
Yeah. One of those days.
Yeah.
Reach Around Radio on a Monday. Traffic jam mix with DJ always at the top. I'm the guy right here in this seat, TEP. But right now.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, it's your birthday, girl.
Oh, shit.
What's his name?
Already?
And I heard you downloaded our Reach Around Radio app. So we must bless you with this gracefully. Sit down and relax. Take this brown paper bag. Everything in this brown paper bag is yours, baby. Except the lemon heads and the pineapple crush is mine. But
I love it.
Everything else. Happy birthday, Robin Ray, on our Reach Around Radio team. She downloaded our app.
Oh, nice.
So she gets a sexy birthday shout out at the top of.
We got a lot of birthdays.
The hour. Bitch, I'm not talking to you.
Oh!
Ladies and gentlemen.
Punch in the mouth.
Happy birthday, Robin Ray. And everybody else that has a birthday coming up.
We'll give you shots later.
This is TDP, Mr. 123 Knox. Baby!
She must have let you hit.
No.
I know, because it's like, why is that one singled out?
No, and like at the beginning.
You want to say your name?
Because she let me know she downloaded the app, so I appreciated that.
Okay.
So I wanted to take the time. Let me know that she downloaded our Reach Around Radio app.
And
I wanted to get her birthday, sexy birthday, off the top.
Well, I have a request.
You have a request?
Okay, well, it's Nikki Pam in the house, but okay. I have a request since my birthday's coming up, and I don't know that we'll be back. Can I get a sexy shout out?
I want it for later.
I want my own separate. I don't want to be bunched. I want it for Speedy and
Bunchy. So you want both to do it?
I want you. Oh yeah, both to do me.
Oh, come on, Nikki Pam, that ain't right. First,
I mean, you're mad.
I want to be bunch. I want it for Speedy and
Bunchy.
So you want both to do it?
I want you. Oh yeah, both to do me.
Oh, come on, Nikki Pam, that ain't right. First,
I mean, your mouth.
Yeah.
And I don't want mine lumped in with everybody else. I want something special. I was gonna say something else, but I chose
Delphonics.
And speaking of our app,
talk about
the Reach Around Radio app is now available.
Thank you.
Please go to our website and click on either the Android, icon.
Your story.
You made it up.
Android icon.
Or click the podcast box.
Podcast
That'll take you to the
box.
iTunes. You search Reach Around Radio. I think it's, what, $2.99?
I was going to ask you how much.
That's nothing.
$2.99.
It's Reach Around Radio. It's your boy, Speed Doggy Dog.
Oh, fuck the app.
Yeah, no, we're going to come back to the app. But Club Fluffy's is open, but I got some complaints.
Uh-oh. Oh, shit.
From the white girls that come to the club, they end up white music.
The Europeans?
Yeah. So we got to break it out a little bit.
What's
it's white night.
Girls like?
was White Knight here at Club Fluffy's.
The whole
DJ
night?
Always. Always. Yeah. Break it off on dog.
Oh my God.
I do show love is a big lady.
I was right here. I was right here.
Now what year is this, Phoebe?
84, 85.
Yeah.
Now, backstory on this.
Is this Billy Idol?
Billy Idol.
Yes. Oh, that's my guy.
So I think I told y'all the story on this.
You probably saw.
You can turn me up a little more. I think I told you for sure. This song was came from Billy Idol's sister was gonna marry a brother.
Okay. Oh wow.
And then if you listen to the lyrics, it really tells you, oh, you go, yeah.
Oh damn, it's racist.
Yes, yes.
Oh no.
Who's the only one? Turn it up, always.
Yeah, we gotta listen.
Hey little sister, who's this Superman? Hey little sister, who's the one you want? Hey little
shake
sister,
shake them titties,
shotgun. Nice day to start again.
Come on, I don't know how you did this lip.
Nice
wedding. Yeah, for a white wedding. So my boy, this white guy told me this story, and I'm like, get the fuck out of here. Now listen to the lyrics. Sure enough.
And you got upset?
So the hook doesn't match the verse, though, to me. So he's saying he likes the wedding?
No, no. He said it's time for a white wedding.
Oh, and all... Ooh, damn. No, he didn't. Oh, that's disturbing.
So he was mad?
Yeah.
Very.
That is so disturbing.
He's from Europe. He's really European.
But they got black
and
people
that,
there.
What's that, the 80s, too? What's that?
Yeah.
Yeah.
But they were still like, fuck us.
Oh, okay.
But it's okay. It's a white night here at Club Fluffy's.
Well, way to start out with that song, Steve.
No, right. Way to bring us down.
And speaking of white, RT is running late. So
he ain't really white. Right.
He'll be back. I had a dream about RT.
Oh. Sexual?
It was sexual.
Before you get it.
Oh.
It was sexual?
I'll wait till he gets here.
Oh, I'm out of here, this.
Well, I'm having a dream about you right now with this top on.
Yeah.
I didn't know
Speedy
your chest
was begging. Titty Speedy was begging to see the areolas.
I just made her a bet. I'm going to put it on the air because she ain't had no weed in 2 days.
Wow, Speedy.
Because right now she's joining. I'm going to buy you a sack. I just want to see him.
Hmm.
I don't want to touch him.
You have to buy me a pound of weed.
Wow.
I'm a pound in the weed. Then. No, I'll buy you a nice dub sack. Just to look.
Oh,
how you know what a nice dub set look like, Sweetie?
She knows.
They don't even. A dub set is barely a blunt these days.
I know.
So what? I need? Hmm?
You need to buy me a pound.
Can't get a pound.
Oh well.
I'd have to hit for a pound.
Wow.
You thinking about it, though?
She like, well, like, damn,
well, it's only going to be 3 minutes.
So they say.
She
said only 3 minutes.
She did look up like she was like considering it.
For a minute, she went, this nigga, really?
No.
Like, if he show me a front, well, then maybe I could do it.
So what you doing, huh? I'm at your door with this weed in my pocket. No, they look beautiful. I must say, pee your chest, man.
Come on, sweet. This is really impressive.
I don't know what these dudes doing out here.
I know, sexual harassment.
No, I'm saying, I don't know what's wrong with these dudes. She's cute. Got the biddies. You gonna smoke a little weed with you. You gonna wear Timberlands together. Hey, where my chuck? Keep my chucks, bitch. I like that.
Hilarious.
I think you mad cool.
Thank
and
you.
Pam, you know, me and you just gonna fuck.
Wow. Wow.
We ain't gonna do
well,
that.
You're halfway there.
We're gonna have our threesome later, so...
I'm for your birthday?
He said
I'm nervous.
Sonny's here.
For what?
Why you look like a rapist? What's wrong with
that? He looks like a ninja today.
A yellow ninja. What's with all the black? Oh, you're on a bike. My bad. Let's move on.
It is cold outside.
It is.
So what, how was your
week? It was 39 degrees this morning.
Oh, my God.
You ain't got no thermometer.
I checked the weather.
On weather.com.
I hate you, Speedy.
That's 39. Right?
I need to put a Band-Aid on this one.
Well, it was 29 up at the mansion.
Oh, yeah, it is
was
cold
it
out
heated?
There.
I'm sure.
Yes, it was.
I have no heat.
Oh,
why not?
Oh, that's what you still don't have heat?
Because the heater needs to be cleaned out because it can't build ventilate. Up. So
okay.
I got waiting for somebody to come by and clean my heater out.
Wow, that was so nice.
Check this out. Now I know you need things.
So you want my filter.
So do you want the weed or the heater?
I can buy you a portable heater.
What you need? You need to be warm. You need to be hot. What you
speed,
I'm at that age
speedy,
now where
speedy.
I don't back no more. I'm just
all you gotta do,
pull up my money
clean
now.
Clean our heater, take the lint and stuff out of that, roll that up.
Or they got come portable on, ones at Walgreens for $21.
So look
I
here.
Just bought.
I I might have to do that.
Need me to come through?
21.
For what, Speedy?
To clean your shit up.
No.
Come on.
I ain't gonna tell nobody, P.
Let them adjust your thermostat.
Right. It'll be right on the radio.
Yeah, it'll be so
posted on Twitter.
Right outside your door.
She got skills.
How was your week?
Well, we already know that.
Yeah, we know you got skills.
My week was good. It's still the beginning of the week.
Your hair is lovely.
Oh, you mean last week or last 2 weeks?
Come back to me so I can remember.
I'm going to come right now.
Go to you, Speedy, and then come back to me.
Took the kids. Well, I didn't take the kids. Fox took the kids to Disneyland.
Again.
Ooh, it's cold.
Again.
Nice.
My kids go like, it's brand new. Like, they ain't never been.
Bye, Daddy.
Oh, you didn't go, Speedy?
No, I was there.
Oh, you went. Okay.
But cool thing about this time, my granddaughter, who turned one on the day we went, she,
oh my
Donald
God,
bought her.
Is it one?
She's one.
Wow.
And she's walking. She is so cute.
I haven't
seen
any.
She's so cute.
I got them.
Oh, good. I'm
sorry. And she's walking. It's funny, but she's hilarious.
Mm-hmm.
And Donald's hilarious because he's not me.
Has he changed?
No.
Is he a different kind of dad? Damn.
Donald is mean.
Donald is mean.
Yes.
Okay.
Oh,
Donald
yes.
is the mean uncle, mean.
Like controlling
yes.
and bossy.
Yes.
Yeah, because I asked Tiffany, I said, when are you going to bring the baby up?
Right.
And
one.
I got to ask Donald.
Wow.
Oh,
the baby
no.
ain't going nowhere.
Oh.
I can't even get her.
I'm kick Donald's ass.
That's crazy. I remember when that relationship first started.
Yeah.
First, you was trying to hit.
No, I never tried to hit.
No, Speedy wasn't trying to
never
hit.
Never tried
That's
to
real.
Hit.
He wasn't trying
well,
to
no,
hit.
Well, no, she was trying to hit my ex-boyfriend, remember?
Wow.
I'm just saying, she was with my ex. I'm sorry.
Wow.
Uh-oh, I think you,
you know,
may have endangered
her. You know, I do got a grandbaby around here.
Oh, sorry,
I think
my
you
bad.
May have endangered her.
Okay, never mind. I'm just
wow.
playing.
All right, Tina. That's the way his ass was.
My bad.
So, no, here's the funny thing. So, anyway.
Okay.
So, Donna was putting on a birthday party at his grandmother's house for the baby.
Right.
So, I call him. I give him some money to go get the baby, whatever. And he's like, oh, Dad, can't get enough. Ain't got to do this. I said, well, you should tell me you need some more money. I said, well, we're going to Disneyland. Well, just come to Disneyland and bring the baby.
Right.
I mean, how many people are actually going to show up? He was like, just you and the kids. I said, dude, we all going to Disneyland. Fox said it's cool.
Uh-huh.
Come on. So sure he come. So they still, his other side of the family, they're at the grandmother's house chilling, waiting on Donald and the baby.
Wow.
They sent a picture. Everybody sitting like this.
Now, is that wow. the Matterhorn?
So they sent a picture of everybody that was at the party waiting on the baby to show up, and Donald didn't show up. So they was
wow.
they was upset. Yeah, it was hilarious.
They made this big old pot of greens for nothing.
And you know, in 1 year, you overdo it. Well, you got to do kids.
Right.
But the kid that's one, for some reason, you overdo it. Like Brooklyn, we spent $600. He don't remember none of it.
Right.
Maya, the same right. thing. It's just
because it's the first birthday.
It's the first one, right. and you ain't really. And next birthday, everything come down.
Right.
Every
right.
birthday, it trust me, kids.
Chuck E. Cheese.
Man.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Be at the house.
Right.
Mama made you a cake. Somebody make an ice
order
cream.
Order pizza.
Order pizza.
Right.
So next thing you know, you getting some clothes.
Right.
I got you some Damn. Shoes. But it was fun, and I once again, I appreciate Fox is always looking out for my
little kids
because they don't even want to see me no more. Where is Uncle Jamie? I'm like,
really?
I do drop y'all over there. Yeah. Shit, I am the chauffeur.
Pull over right here, nigga. We can walk.
And so I'm buying. So I got one thing I learned. So I let Fox do all of it. He buy kids shit, I step out the way.
Right.
But he had bought his daughter this little
that
light up star.
So cute too.
He bought her a light up star. So my two little girls looking at me like so
yeah,
I dash and go get I go get a couple stars.
Okay.
As I'm coming back, before I even get to my kids, there's other little girls. Thank you, Uncle Speedy.
Oh, they took them from you?
Man, Dave Brown's daughter took this. I said,
oh, Dave went.
Wow.
So Maya said, where's mine?
It's over there.
You get it from that little girl.
Right, go jackers.
I had to go back and buy some more, man. The motherfuckers was like $15 a pop.
Yeah, nothing at Disneyland or Magic
they
Mountain
are
or whatever.
It's like over $100 to get in now,
it's
right?
ridiculous.
Well, I just
for
found
how much
out.
Is it for kids? What, like $50?
Well, I just found out
uh-huh.
when Fox does the, when he do it,
uh-huh.
it's $100 a person.
Oh.
It's 37 people.
That ain't nothing.
But 30? We get the, I told you we get to
yeah,
cut everybody.
VIP, yeah.
We get to cut the handicap, everybody. You
right.
in a wheelchair, excuse me.
Right.
Excuse
me. Hold up, polio. I'm getting ready to ride this one.
Right.
And they because we 30 deep.
Right.
Plus.
Right.
So people looking at us like, really? excuse me, right. All the kids.
Right.
I know that's right.
We took about, in Small World, we took 1, 2, 3 cars.
Oh, dang.
Small
World. I love that ride, though.
Did they remodel in there?
Hell no. That motherfuckers do the same movements.
It's the same thing, but it's still cute.
No, it ain't.
To me, Disneyland is the...
It is.
I won't.
It's money.
It's boring.
It's money.
It's for kids.
I was going to say, it's the wackest museum park in L.A. to me.
Magic really? Mountain is the shit.
Yeah, I love it. Well, that's
my favorite
grown folks.
Is Universal Studios.
Really? Yeah.
Really?
That ain't real.
Yeah.
It's like money. 3-4 rides. Yeah, I mean,
it's not about the rides. They have other attractions.
I
there.
Bet they do.
I'm with Speedy with Magic Mountain.
She's like, she can walk
I'm
and smoke weed.
I'm not a roller
coaster
person.
She can walk and smoke weed.
Yeah, that's what she's like about.
They're like a vaporizer.
She's going to vaporize her own.
Right.
Can't be walking through Disneyland with a vaporizer.
I know why you don't like Magic Mountain. They got that line.
Yeah, it's full
line. No,
lines.
The line. You got to be certain heights.
Oh,
she's like,
that's
what?
Wrong.
Really?
I'm not a rides person. I don't like roller coasters.
Your
shit, oh, I love them.
I can imagine. Your...
Just like your belly.
Wow.
Oh, damn.
All right.
That's
right. You don't want to start another fight in here.
I know, right?
Heard they fighting in this building.
Shout out to Scott.
Beat him up.
Bizzle.
Beat him up.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, we heard that Scott and Bizzle got into a little...
On their show?
Here in the studio.
Oh, wow.
So you imagine when it came time
like
to
like a knockdown drag here. Out or just cussing each other out?
So you might heard somebody got hands put on them.
Oh, shit.
So you know.
I don't know.
So now you got to do the show. Yes. Your lip is all big.
Drop.
Your lip is all big.
So look here. This next subject.
Wow.
Yeah, I'm going home. Please. That's me and Teeter get into it. It's over. The show's over.
Yeah.
Hilarious.
We ain't doing no more shows.
So who will win between in a fight between you guys?
I wouldn't fight you.
I wouldn't fight you. We've been boys too long.
Yeah. Nah, he's too doughy. I wouldn't.
All right, enough about your story. What you been up to, TDT?
Oh, you know, taking the Thanksgiving holiday down in Escondido.
Oh, you were down by me.
What the hell is that?
Yeah.
We were right
down
next
in
to each other.
San Diego.
I was in San Marcos.
Yeah. He's down
with,
there with
who's
the...
Who's you with, Tia, dude?
Yeah.
The fam bam.
Your family's down there?
Yeah, I got family.
You know, we don't know where he lives. We don't know anything about him.
Yeah, nigga, he is so. Tommy Ford from Mark.
I know.
I love it like that.
I'm like, oh, you got family. Okay.
So, you know.
Who knows?
You live where?
Love it.
So, you know, with the family and all that, you know, we had like 3 different types of, stuffing. Mm. So you got the regular, then the cornbread, then you got the oyster stuff.
Oh, I love oysters.
Yeah. Oh, my God.
Oysters off the chain.
Oh,
oysters.
Who cooked?
My aunt.
She got an aunt name?
Yeah.
No. He ain't going to tell us.
My aunt Jill.
That's I have an aunt Jill.
Yeah. Aunt white. Jill cooked. So they cooked at the one house, and then, you know, they got to bring it over to the other house with the other family. Mm. So, you know, it's like that, so everybody bringing their own dishes and stuff. So, you know, somebody brought some potato salad that had a bone in it.
Mm-mm.
What?
Yeah, you know, the new up and coming nieces want to cook and all that because they got the big old bag.
Up and coming nieces.
Got the big old bag with the. You can't cook.
Right.
It's like, how you get a bone in your mashed potatoes?
Wow. How did that happen?
I have no idea.
They must somebody use a cook. Chicken broth, but from real chicken or something
somebody
to try to
cook.
Make it.
I can cook.
I can too.
So, you know, you got that going on, and then, you know, working on these projects leading up to this day, and it's been fun, and staying out of trouble.
Mm-mm. You ain't got pulled over?
I did got pulled over.
Again?
Again?
I did got. On the back street. Speed, you know the whole back street thing. You know, when it's traffic, you take the
take
back
the back
streets.
Street, yeah.
So now they're putting all these stop signs.
Okay.
On the back street
okay.
now because of the kids and the crossings and all that. So came to the one, it was a new sign, so it kind of startled me that they did have a sign there. So I did stop.
California Road, that's what they call it.
It was less than the California Road because I did stop.
Mentally.
But then I didn't look left and right. And I thank you, DJ, always. That's always with a Z on Twitter. So the motorcycle cop is on the side street.
Waiting.
Especially around that
waiting.
Time, too. They waiting
yeah.
for drunk drivers.
He can get a whole siren a little bit.
So I go through, I see him. I just pull over.
Got out the car?
Got out the car. Had my license in my hand. I said, this is a new sign because it's brand new. It ain't been shot or nothing. It's still red and everything. He said, you know what? I'm going to give you a ticket because you did stop. He said, I'm not going to play with you. You did stop. He said, I catch them when they don't even stop at all.
Brother or white dude?
White boy. Okay. European. Egghead.
Colonizer.
Yeah, him. I said, you know, Mandela, you know, just
my mind was right.
You know, I had a lot on my mind. He said, how'd you get a new license? I said, what you mean? He said, our poor brothers always said, they ain't got this. How'd you get a new one? I said, I'm straight. He said, you are straight. Go on, get out of here.
He didn't give you a ticket?
He didn't give me a ticket.
Oh,
nothing.
Cool.
He went right back there and post up, and then the big old came through in the truck.
What?
You should have stopped.
You still there. Get out the car now.
Get out the car. So that's been my adventures.
Dang.
Tammy?
Nikki Pam?
Let's see.
Did you get
well,
any?
No. Fresh off the Soul Train Christmas party last night.
How was that?
Off the chain. We always have...
Drop!
We always have so much fun. Maxie from the Mary Jane Girls was there. I got to meet her, who was one of my idols.
Is that the first time you meet him?
Yeah. Have you met her before?
Uh-huh.
Oh, okay. Yeah, she's down to earth.
Shut your story up. Yeah.
I ain't shit.
Fuck your story.
You don't know Maxie?
Is that the first time you met her?
Damn, bitch. You on
phone? She's only been around forever.
She is the only white girl in the group.
No, but I was like, oh, my God, I wanted to be you so bad. Wait, and I'm such a
And bitch, you still do.
Right. I was like, I pulled out my picture of my Mary Jane girls that I think I posted it on Twitter or something a while ago. I was like, this is me. I thought I was you. And she was like, oh, that's nice.
Did you say, did you fuck like Alexander?
Wow. He told me.
Hi the time. He told me.
And so I found out she had a son. I didn't know that. Well, a photo to
she
me like, yeah,
bitch. No.
She was
looks
so
good.
Skinny.
She looks good.
But I mean, she had a lot of makeup on, but.
She like the typical white girl.
So I asked her, were they going to tour? Are they going to get back? Are they going to do anything? She said, no, she's moving on. She said she's over it. Just too many issues, personality issues. They got a group of songs. Five at least.
Two songs to say.
Boys, Candyman, All Night Long.
Boys,
Girls. Oh, I love that song. I remember the video. I was like, you said, like, I'm such a geek. I said, but if you just do decide to get back together, I know all the steps, so you can call me. I can fill in
for
you. I'm like, I know all the videos. She was like, oh, okay, that's cute.
I
was
such a geek.
No, she really She went, okay.
But she was,
ladies and gentlemen, coming to the stage, Mary Jane Girls and Pam. Mary Pam. Right. With her air guitar.
But that made my night. Actually, that made my year. Because, I mean, meeting your idol from childhood. I mean, like, when I met Shee Lee, we know what happened there.
Yeah.
I mean, and her, she was definitely in
but
my top
you
five.
Over, like.
Yes, I was talking fast. You know, I was like, my bad. I'm sorry. I don't understand.
I was the same way
stop.
When I met...
I was...
When you met who?
Your first lover.
Jill Scott.
Oh, I met her a
couple
times.
I couldn't even get it together.
I was that way.
Really?
Couldn't get together. I was backstage with her and Fox asked,
Prince.
Like... Oh, thanks. My boy is in. I'm sitting there going, nigga, really? Really? She's like, oh, no, you're cute. I'm like,
oh.
Aww. I shut down.
You go into another mode.
Man.
And, you know, we've been
around. Like one of my gummy bears now?
We've all been around a lot of celebrities, but there was one or two or three that, like,
maybe. And they're probably not even a big celebrity.
No,
you just
it's
appreciate
not.
Their
Who was
music.
Yours?
Yeah.
I acted that way around Kindred, the Family Soul, when I met them.
Oh, really?
Because I was so hooked on their first album. And they were like, they were real cool, but they were like, okay.
Like, calm down.
So you were just like, what were you doing? Just like, hey, I like.
Oh, man, I love y'all stuff. Woo, woo, woo. I was following them around a little bit.
You're going to stalk them all.
And I normally don't do that because I've been in the business. I grew up around celebrities. So, but there's a few that, when I appreciate their music,
yeah, you can't
know,
help
I gotta
it.
Gotta give them their props.
What rapper did you like?
I don't know. I gotta think about that one.
Yeah.
But Pam, you finished your
question? Yeah, I was done with that.
Okay.
Yeah.
Last week,
uh-huh.
I went to Bishop Don Juan's birthday party.
Uh-oh.
I love the bishop.
Yep.
We go to this place. It was at this smoke. Legal smokehouse.
Okay.
Like, when I come in, when I walk in the door, they got the DJ up in there. They got the stripper in the strip pole.
Uh-huh.
And,
mm-hmm.
and then...
it's a party.
And then Bishop had his own table. And so he had the everything going on.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm. But when I left, I saw on one of his Instagram pictures that one of the strippers' coochie was on fire.
Huh?
Like, literally...
Oh, was that a trick? Fire?
Shooting flames.
Oh, that was a trick.
And I was like, damn.
She's a flamethrower at night.
And of course, Bishop. He's always
like, who else was there besides him? Like, what other celebrities?
Just his whole crew. It was a small place.
Did he have on green?
Huh?
Did he have on green?
I don't remember what he had on, but it was a small place.
Uh-huh.
And I was like, is this legal? Because niggas was bringing their own bottles and shit. I was like, this
that's a speakeasy. Like,
yeah,
that's called a speakeasy.
Yep.
Was the spot. Mm-hmm. That was the spot. So sure, happy birthday to Bishop Don Juan. And we got a lot of Team RAR birthdays that we'll get to later in the show. And it's Reach Around Radio.
Yeah.
Yep.
Hit
top
us
of the
up
hour
on YouTube. Don't forget to
subscribe to our YouTube channel.
And download our app. And we got special guests coming up. We're waiting for RT, and we'll be right back. Give it up for my man, DJ Always.
In the mix.
In the mix.
He did steal this song. Let me hear the other version. Let me hear the stolen version.
Did they really
just sound just like it.
Blurred lines.
Blurred lines, yes. Just like it.
But the white boy didn't steal it. Somebody else produced it.
Cowbell.
As soon as you hear this motherfucker, you'd be like, Phil, what's your name? Cowbell.
Same bass line.
Yeah. Pharrell, you owe the money, Pharrell. Go on and pay it up. It's Reach Around Radio. It's your boy Speed Dog, and the house ladies.
I'm the poet.
Yes, you are.
Oh. It's the finger bang falsetto. TP, Mr. 1-2-3 Knox. Baby.
Every time he says finger bang, my mind goes right there. I don't know why.
So does my finger.
Bang.
Sorry, Nikki Pam in the house.
When last time you been finger bang, Pam?
It's been a long time.
Wow.
A long time.
At least you remember. And Speed Dog, you know. Once again, Club Fluffies is under siege.
Siege?
I've been told we need to change up the music. White Boys in the house, White Boy Effect, White Boy Funk House. Tonight, break it off for me always.
Miss me.
Oh, hey,
I know
Culture
you
Club.
Miss me. I know you miss me, beloved.
Pam, I know you was a boy,
Jordan. Oh, I'll be like. Miss me.
Hilarious.
That's how he did.
Moskoska.
It was weird watching this video because you wanted to go, is that a dude or a
you
girl?
You never knew, especially that
big ass girl.
I know your kidney beans.
You know what?
Kidney beans.
Hilarious. It's Reach Around.
Can I tell my boy George story?
Yes.
You kissed him?
No. Was out in Covina.
Mm-mm.
This is where they had the Music Plus.
Okay, cool.
So I get the best of Burt Bacharach.
I will slap the shit out of
you. Like, what?
The best of Burt Bacharach.
Yeah.
Like you had all the other ones.
Yeah, they wrote all of Dionne Warwick stuff.
Yeah.
Isaac Hayes.
Oh, that's true.
Burt Bacharach.
Yeah, he got mad money. He got money.
So I get Burt Bacharach. I get, what was the name of that group? POV.
Oh, yeah.
At the time.
POV. And,
I remember them.
You know what I'm talking about. And I get
Boy George.
The best culture club. So the dude looked behind the counter because his brother was working at the time. He's like, you like Boy George? He gay. I'm like, I don't care. His music is great.
Slamming.
And I'm going to play it as soon as I get in the car. And that's when I had the old school.
Old school, the blue, was it Cutlass?
No, that was the GS.
Regal or something.
Yeah. So I put Boy George in the dash, so I pull right up to the door and I'm banging this. I'm gonna make him move. So he, you know, the window's right there, so he's facing that way. So I'm banging, he turned around and he was shaking his shoulder. I said, yeah, who gay now? Oh my God. Love.
Was he really gay?
Love.
Or he just like, who's gay?
I don't know.
Yeah, he was in a. relationship actually with what's the girl? Oh God!
Scrambled Eggs.
Your story.
No. He was in a relationship, and oh, what's that group? Oh, the blonde. Okay,
you get the story together.
I have to come back all to right.
it,
but
I'm gonna tell y'all this. If it ever get out, I'm gonna slap shit out of y'all if it ever get out. So, Keith Sweat had just dropped.
Hysterical.
Just dropped. So I go. Just let me finish it because you can figure it out before that. So I go into the record store and I'm going to buy Keith Sweat. So I'm looking in the W's. Goddamn. Fuck. They ain't got it here. So I dash to another record store.
Why are you looking in the W's?
You let me finish the story. That's what I said. You got to let me finish the story.
You can't spell.
So I go to
wet,
another.
Wet.
So I go to. I'm like, I'm just. Because I'm trying to get it. Wait.
Wet.
I'm trying to get the album before I get on the road. I'm about to go on the road. So I go to another record store. I'm like, God damn, man, the W. What the fuck is Keith Sweat? Fuck. So I said, my man, y'all got Keith Sweat? He said, yeah, it's right there in the S. You're right.
Said, okay, windings,
It's a V in this.
Oh, my God.
I went to three different record stores. This is how long ago it was. I went to three different warehouses.
Yes, sir.
Looking for Keith Sweat. That first album. Because the first album was bananas.
See, that's the thing that these kids now don't appreciate, just going to the music store,
just
thumbing
there.
Through
oh,
music.
Man. Oh, I know. For hours.
Man,
and if,
hours.
And if you
reading go, album covers for hours.
Just see who produced what.
Yeah.
And then, like, I would go to a record store and ask people to work there, what's some hot shit that's out that nobody knows about? And they turned me on to this girl named Adrienne Evans. And she played all the instruments. Her album is off the chain. Adrienne Evans.
Adrienne Evans.
Go get that. It's off the chain. First album is a beast. But nobody knew about her. My man at the VIP, you don't know about VIP record store.
In Long Beach.
But the warehouse right there in Ladera. Used to be in Ladera.
Oh, yeah, right that's, off on La Brea.
That was the longest.
La Brea and Coliseum.
Adrienne Evans right here. This is her.
This is her. Oh, that's, my God. Go
when
ahead.
I tell you this album is a beast.
Oh, wow.
But she was under the radar. This is right before, what was it called? Fuck my story. Okay.
Yeah. We don't.
Okay, back to the story. Like I was saying.
She fuck your story.
Hysterical.
Call back, caller. The number is 323-522-5482. That's right. Right about now.
Oh, that was your electrical voice. Do that again.
Oh, here we go, too. Speed Doggy Dog, DJ Always.
Yeah.
Nikki Pam, you too.
Yeah.
Look at her coming back from that party with Bishop.
Oh.
Look at her stumbling up the driveway.
Yes, she did.
With a little bit of legs up, with a little bit of legs. That muck is all out.
Oh, look at her.
That muck is all out.
So hot. That song came on the other day and I kept going.
I know.
With their legs up, somebody's like, I was like, I'm sorry.
I know.
Before we get into the stories, we want to send a rest in peace to.
Rest in power.
Rest in power to Nelson Mandela.
Yes. I have been working on that
is
all
Fox
weekend.
Is Fox going out there? To South Africa?
Not there.
Oh, he's not?
Yeah. It seems
President
like.
Is there.
Well, the big funeral is tomorrow in the stadium. Mm-hmm. And then he lays in rest Friday and Saturday. And then they'll have the,
No, that's right. That's the right music. We need
and
the
then
channel
he lays in rest Friday and Saturday, and the Sunday is the actual funeral. But it starts at like 2 in the morning tonight.
Yeah,
the
they
other
said Barack
thing, so.
Is doing a wave and app.
Oh, really?
Trust none of them. They said he's leaving. His wife's going to stay a little longer, but they said Barack is in and out. Hey.
So he won't be for there for the Sunday for the actual burial.
No,
okay, because they're going to, on Friday and Saturday, kind of take him to where he was born and parade him through the. What is it, the country
the
or whatever?
They
yeah, they're doing that. But they do that to presidents. They do that to presidents, though. They did that to Reagan. I remember
don't worry,
for like
won't.
A week.
Caller, what's your name and where you calling from?
Come on there.
Yes. You on there. Who this?
Hey, what's up? It's T-Dog.
Hey,
T-Dog.
We haven't heard from you in like a year.
You been in jail?
No, Speedy. In and out of the country, man.
Oh, you're out of the country. Where you been to Cuba?
Actually, yeah, while you're playing, yeah. That's one of them, yeah.
You went to Cuba?
I thought I'm talking about boy. Just tell the story.
You know, I got family out there, too. But I was calling to get back in the States, calling and see how y'all are doing, man.
Do you listen wherever you are? wherever you're in, whatever country you're
whatever
in?
We are. No, I'm back right now. I'm back in Miami right now, so
oh, I can get that.
How's the weather in Miami, T Dog?
77 degrees.
Nice.
Who? 77 degrees. 77s in your thermometer.
But
How many ostriches? How many ostriches you buy when you went to Cuba? How many ostriches did you buy when you was in Cuba? 777. Huh? We got a bad connection.
I can't.
No, I just wanted to give me a shout out my birthday on Thursday.
Okay.
We ran out of time, T-Dog.
No problem, T-Dog. I got you.
Okay, you bought 777 ostriches when you was in Cuba.
We got to go.
And it's your birthday.
We got it.
Bless your heart, T-Dog.
Bye, T-Dog.
On Thursday, my birthday.
I got you. Okay. Well, we're not going to be on Thursday.
Well, you studied long enough for your birthday to come up.
T, you got to have somebody write your shit down.
You ain't so, nice,
baby. Huh?
I am happy that you guys, you know.
You said
awesome.
Big Bub got a new album coming out. What you say?
I fucking hate you.
Huh? You bought 777 ostriches, and Big Bub got a new album coming out, and it's your birthday on Thursday, T-Dog? Am I right?
Hey, I will donate again, too. I'm back in the States. I'm going to shoot y'all some more.
Yeah,
wait a minute. You bought 777 ostriches. Big Bub has got a new album coming out, and you made an omelet? What did you say?
I'm going to donate, homie. I'm going to make sure I get up with y'all.
Thank you, T-Dog.
All right,
let's get to these
stories. Hey, happy birthday to you, too, T-Dog.
Oh, happy birthday.
That's
I got
the big
you,
home.
Sweet.
All right, y'all too. Right.
777 ostriches.
Oh, my God.
Who album you buy? Whose album
Big
did you buy?
Bub does
big
have
Bub.
A new album coming out.
T-Dog said that. Hurry. He was challenging him.
All right.
And he didn't even know it.
Wendy's customer finds half-smoked blunt in her hamburger. Did y'all hear about that?
Oh,
did
wow.
you work there?
That's where her other 2 days a week went.
Allegedly, a Wendy's employee was arrested last month in Georgia after making a cheeseburger with weed in it.
Wow.
Oh.
I got high on y'all
ATL.
Burger, nigga. Shame.
The customer, well, actually, the woman who put the blunt in the burger says that she actually was smoking weed on the job, and she misplaced her blunt.
She was rolled and everything.
Hold on, let me see if I got this right. How high do you we go?
Talk about this is relish.
Put this on these pickles.
How are you?
And with that bitch walk. All right, cool.
This got to be graveyard.
But wait.
It's got to be graveyard.
It ain't morning shift.
Yeah, it ain't morning shift.
Where do you smoke weed on your job at McDonald's,
right.
though?
Right.
No, Burke. Was it Burke? Was it McDonald's? Like,
it was Wendy's. Yeah. Oh, yeah, Wendy's.
Mm-hmm. Wendy's burgers is good, too.
Yeah.
Put a little weed. I bet somebody bit down. Nigga, that's not a Philly blunt.
She's Philly blunt.
Well, she said she had been smoking the weed at work.
I love it, though.
She told on herself.
Which later turned up inside the customer's cheeseburger. The blunt was taken as evidence. And, of course, needless to say, she was fired and arrested.
Oh, I would have told. I would have admitted to that.
The person that bit the burger, you think they sued?
Yeah. Well, actually, they're claiming they were food poisoned.
Mm.
Ain't no way.
Food poisoned.
Well, not if you don't smoke, and then you get the weed and the paper.
You got to play it all the way through.
So you're going to tell me she chewing everything, too?
Yeah,
come
you got to go
she
all the way. I'll show up to court.
Oh, ugh.
Yeah, I'm going to come to court with my mouth all wired. I'm going to be all
Well, I mean, yeah, of course I would have took it
well,
to the
Well, she claimed
but...
she was hospitalized. So
oh,
I think this smells
she
like a lawsuit.
Yeah. Oh, and
but McDonald's would have paid her right off the top.
Oh,
Wendy's?
That
is so funny.
McDonald's paid right off the
top. Well, they did. Let's see. Did they? Oh, they offered to help pay for the medical bills. And has given generously by throwing a $50 gift certificate.
No,
no.
Now, if they're willing to pay, that means they're willing to kick
to Wendy's, too?
You go back and get some more weed?
Shit.
Yep.
Wendy's good, though.
It is good, but that wouldn't have done it for me.
Who would do it for you?
I would have, like, $100,000 lawsuit.
See, that had to be graveyard shift, because, you know, you in there chilling and going on. Let me light this up. Then. You know, 2 in the morning, the club let out in that drive-thru, get the crack. Oh!
Hey, niggas is here.
Hey, wait, wait.
Put the lettuce on top of the blunt, get the patty on the bun, and wrap it up and throw it out the window. Yeah, get busy. Yeah. Quick. So I can see what she messed
wait,
up.
Wait, Tina act like
why
his
she
experience.
Telling herself, though? This is when niggas start telling her.
Yeah, I would have been. I don't know where that shit came from.
You the only one working.
But somebody barely probably would have told on me, though.
Why you say that?
Because everybody knows, you know.
Yeah, it's that one.
Medicaid.
It's that one.
Yeah, they'll be, she be coming in here smelling like that.
Right. Right. It ain't fries.
Exactly. Okay. So man funny. Spends $750 for a picture of an Xbox One console.
Huh?
So what he did, he went on eBay. Mm-hmm. And this guy was actually, the seller was actually selling a picture of an what? Xbox.
Wow.
Huh?
So this guy said, well, he purchased it because it was in the video games and consoles category on eBay.
Okay.
But what he got was a picture of an Xbox that he paid $750 and wasn't even a good picture. It was like magenta. You know how when your ink is starting to run out?
Oh, magenta.
Did you say magenta? Is that in your story? You put that in.
It's in the story. But the guy says he was buying this Xbox for his 4-year-old for Christmas. Uh-huh. Why do you buy a 4-year-old?
I know. It must be the new one, too. Because there's a new one that just came out.
Are they $750?
Yeah, the new one.
Six. I thought it was
really?
$600.
Because a new iPhone 5, what, S is damn near $800?
Yeah.
Damn near.
Are they that expensive?
Yeah. Well, for the high megabytes, yeah.
Megabytes.
Megabytes.
Wow.
Yeah, somebody in computer savvy. Yeah.
Can't get a megabyte.
They 15 gigabytes.
I need to go to Wendy's.
Give me a bite.
Yeah.
Not computer savvy, Mom.
But he knows.
What's the email?
He can't even say he was conned because it clearly said clearly stated it was a picture.
Oh, play on words.
So the
he
guy
must have been high.
Yeah, he went to Wendy's.
Yeah, he must have been
he's
high.
The one bit the burger.
Yeah.
Because they actually categorized it underneath the wrong thing, it sounds like.
No, yeah. If dude put it's a picture for $700, you ain't really looking at it's a picture. You're going, nigga, I'm buy that. Send the $7, you dumbass. You send the $7. He send you a picture, and you're like, I'm going to whoop somebody.
Did he get
ass.
His money back?
No.
He bought a $700 picture.
Yeah, he bought it. Damn. It's yours.
Better frame it.
Frame it.
And don't you bid on it?
Mm-hmm.
On
yeah, you bid.
He outbid somebody.
Yeah.
Bitch, you ain't got more money than me.
He outbid somebody.
Somebody else was like, damn, I wanted that picture.
Yeah. I have another one just like it.
And speaking of fast food, have you guys heard the story about the people who drove through the drive-through and instead of getting their food, they got a bag of money?
No.
Which drive-thru?
I wish.
At McDonald's.
Which one? Damn. Which one?
How much?
It was in Tennessee.
Oh, how much? I can't make it.
It didn't say how much was in the bag, but these people go there every morning to order their breakfast, and when they got home and opened the bag, there was money in the bag and a deposit slip. So, I'm thinking an employee was trying to do the make, because how you going
to
put money in a
and they went to, right, wait a minute, did they take it back?
They took it back.
Okay, here's a question.
I knew you was glad.
Pam, do you take it back?
Nah, I'm sorry. I'm going to keep it real. Hell no.
Teeter.
Okay, I don't know this for sure, but when you have friends, it's back in the day when they're working in the fast food place, and you know when you coming through the car, Speedy, and you acknowledge them, you blow, and they on the register, because you know you get ready to go through the drive-thru.
They hook it up.
And right. It's always that one car that jump in front of you
and
mess up everything.
Okay.
So that's what they was doing. They was doing a pass out the window.
Because here's the deposit slip.
And a car cut in front of them. It messed up the whole get down.
Wow.
So that's how they got
it. So the question remains. Do you take it back, T?
Yeah, I take it back.
I would take it back because...
I'm not taking it back there.
To the mall.
I'm taking it back.
But you know what?
You know what? Because somebody's going to... Well... Somebody's gonna lose their job.
Here's the real.
They gonna lose
I'm not
anyway,
taking
Tube
nothing
said,
back.
Fuck that. He's keeping.
I'm bringing their bag back and say, can y'all hit me again? But okay. I'm in the mall. Me and the kids. Right. It's Christmas, my wife.
But you know the old running joke is, you know, I found a gang of money with a rubber band wrapped around it. Who lost it? I did. Okay, well, here goes your rubber band.
Yeah, that.
Well, yeah, I don't know.
You'd really take it back?
Well, not now, not in this day and time.
Not in this climate.
not in this unemployment.
Call in if you would actually give it back.
Yeah, call in. The next story is, I know the perfect gift you can get Jamie, the man who has everything.
What the fuck you looking at me for?
You ain't gonna buy Jamie nothing for Christmas?
No.
Wow, Speedy.
Well, they have, if you're looking for a gift for the person that has everything, they have the golden poo-poo pills.
I saw that.
The what? Golden who?
Boo-boo pills.
Page, yeah.
Oh, wow.
How do they work? Why would you want to shit gold?
You want to shit gold?
For what?
It's now possible with gold pills. The pill capsule will set you back $425. It's filled with 24-karat gold leaf and dipped in gold. And it's,
excellent.
When you boo-boo. Get some gold
boo-boo. See, now
gold turd.
I'm just trying to give mine an S.
See, that's gonna start a lot of kidnapping.
No, a lot of people are going to take it to them gold. What's the gold place?
Gold for cash or something?
Yeah, go to the pawn shop. You see Denzel walking down the street. I know he ate with them pills. I'm going to come out that restaurant. I'm going to kidnap when he boo-boo. I'm going to get my money. You know, stuff like that.
But I don't even understand the purpose in that. Is it sort of...
Here's
health
the thing.
Benefits
somebody
to that.
It's probably somebody gay.
Hey, it's Luther. I would like to buy some pills.
That's in Madison, Wisconsin. Uh-uh. Is that how you say
Madison.
It? Yes, Wisconsin. Okay. Clients that owned a place called the Snuggle House.
Okay, I've been there, so I've snuggled.
Hey, Speedy.
They have closed their doors, and what it is a place where you can go and get hugs, like, and cuddle
for
$60 an hour.
Do you cuddle?
Shit.
I like to cuddle. Yeah.
You do?
Uh-huh. I do.
Like get
hugs.
Up of under?
Yeah, I like it.
After or before?
Both.
Aww.
Want to cuddle right
now? No. But anyway, this cuddle house was like $60 an hour for you to cuddle.
Mm-hmm.
But the city has been having a problem with the place because they said that it could mean prostitution.
Yeah. Okay. Of course.
And parking.
Does cuddling lead to...
Yes.
Not really.
Because, yeah, you do. You feel a hard dick on your butt or something. You're like, oh.
You feel what?
He cuddling from the back.
What? Yeah, you're like, oh,
Pam,
shit.
You feel what?
Hard dick on your ass, you know what I mean?
Well, close the door.
You do, you feel it like, me, you know, bitch. When somebody roll over and you're like, oh, shit, he ready. You know what I mean?
I don't know what you're talking about.
That was your Spanish section. That's what you said, Speedy, he ready.
What the fuck you talking about?
A cuddle house.
Cuddle.
Yeah. Wow. Cuddle house.
Because it's cold in
I just can't believe how hard
Wisconsin.
You hard as hell. I can't see you cuddling. I just don't see that in you. I can't see you all snuggled.
You know what? When I like somebody, they really bring the soft side out of me.
Aww.
Yeah, I'm a totally different
You want another
person.
Taco, Jerome?
Dishes.
I can see Pam, though. I just can't
oh,
see
yeah.
Oh, it is.
Pam is a sweetheart all around.
Aww.
Pam like to get fucked.
Whatever. Wow, sweetie. Like, you know.
I've been told.
Here's our last story. An Alberta man who stabbed a friend in the chest as a test for what turned out to be an ineffective stab-proof vest. His friend was trying to make...
Stab me, nigga! I just bought this motherfucker.
No,
it's a
he made it. So man. He was made a stab... Oh, really he was trying work. To make a stab-proof vest.
Hey, Larry, bring me them curtains out the back!
And he asked his friend to stab him to test it out.
Mm-hmm.
And he stabbed him and it went right through his chest.
Ow!
Oh, my God.
Hold up. Didn't work. this ain't the right prototype.
So, needless to say,
oh my God.
He was arrested.
People are so
that
stupid.
That has to be in Guess What Race.
I know, right?
White.
Of course.
Ain't no point I go, hey, Tito. Grab that blade, see if this shit works. Nigga, please. Tigo put too much on it.
Right.
He'll hit me where it ain't.
That's like trying to get a brother to hold a bottle rocket. Put it on the ground. Right, skip. Right,
right. Hold his firecracker.
Yeah.
Crazy. White boy like, okay.
All right.
How long? You know.
That's crazy.
Wow.
One more quick story. There's now saying for many years that the FBI has had the ability to turn on your camera on your computers without you even knowing.
Right.
Yep.
The light's not coming on.
Yep.
Or anything, so they can watch you if you keep your computers on or your laptop up.
Right.
The government has access.
They sure do.
Damn, I better stop that
smoking. Yes.
Who the other eye?
You know what's scary? Did you guys get that alert?
Yes.
The Amber Alert?
Yes. On your phone?
Yeah.
It's scary.
It was weird because I'm in the furniture store and my phone go, and the little Japanese dude go, and we both look at each other like.
Right. No, it wasn't an Amber Alert. It was something else.
Whatever it was. They hit your phone.
Yeah.
And I don't know if you're in Cali, but it happened here. It hit my phone, the little Japanese dude, and somebody else walking around, and we're all looking at each other like, oh, that's kind of weird.
Yeah.
That the government can reach out and touch you at any time they want.
But they've been had that technology.
But to look through my peephole?
Yeah.
Because I'll be having
mine. Can look through yours on your phone.
I'll be on that, what's the free porn?
Which one?
Hamster. You be jacking off on the camera?
Hamster X.
Oh, I never heard of
that. I put in big bitches like me. And all these big
BBW.
BBW.
There's red, I'm red.
Do you watch BBW porn?
No, read something.
Do you?
Do you? Yes.
You true to it.
No, yes. No, right?
Thank you. That shit look good.
You pop popcorn?
Hey, big fluffy.
I need one more stick of butter.
But some of the girls are not cute. But the girl...
What's your favorite, Speedy?
Cherokee.
That's your girl.
And Pinky cute.
Okay.
Pinky get it.
Oh, but
she only
girls.
Doing girls now.
These
she
are
don't
big
do guys.
Porn girls or something?
Yeah, she don't do guys no more. She do girls.
Okay.
And she wear the strap on. It look kind of weird. Because y'all don't have a rhythm like we got. So her rhythm was all off and she was trying to fuck with the strap on. I'm like, bitch, you don't know. You gotta... It's right in here.
Oh, okay.
It's there. And then once you get the rhythm, you just stay right there.
Ew.
And then once you hit the ribs.
Then you gotta hit that rhythm like.
Okay.
And then you know when to cut it.
Yeah, that's about 3 minutes.
I'm done.
Hilarious.
Thank you for participating. I'll be out in the lobby.
Please turn your lights on when leaving the building.
Fuck them Lakers.
Ladies and gentlemen, lend me your ears. Speedy, you just gonna try to take my gold boo-boo like that?
Teeter.
Sports ticker.
Sports ticker right here on Reach Around Radio. It's going down. Let's just start off with what's going on Monday night. Those Cowboys, Toop and Always squad, playing those Chicago Bears, in the Monsters of the Midway in Chicago. Is it snowing? Are they winning? What's going on? Oh, 7-Up, Coke, Pepsi coming to the end of the first quarter. So the Cowboys need that to get up with those Philadelphia Eagles. In NFL action, AFC East, New England Patriots, Speedy, 10-3. Gronkowski is out.
Ooh, that was
with
bad.
A nice, terrible injury to the leg. Tore it all up.
MCL,
ACI.
Michael Jackson, he tore everything.
And he's pregnant, too. See, this is the thing. You got to let these guys play football. So now we can't hit
you
up high.
You think it was an illegal hit?
No, it's not, Speedy, because once you tell these players that they can't go to the helmet and they can't take them down up top or they might get fined and all that, they got to go low. Ain't no fines.
He a big boy. That's the only way I would have hit him, too.
But as a tight end, he got to know how to jump, too, Speedy.
Well, no, he plant that leg, and that's how you usually blow
still,
it.
Still, once you catch the ball, you got to be looking. You got to be jumping because you know they're going to come down and hit low.
You're rolling on the ground.
You got to get up out of there. In AFC North, Cincinnati, Speedy.
Bingo.
What you think about them? 9-4. You think they got action?
I think they always going to be that kind of team, but they won't get past the first round.
Yeah. Yeah. In the South, Colts, Indianapolis, Naptown. Shouts out to Naptown. 8-5. They took the division. Colts need to work on their running game. Point blank.
I think they figured their way out, though.
They did.
They figured it.
And then they missing Reggie Wayne. That was
didn't
like
he shoot himself or
your boy Luck threw a bad pass behind him, and he tried to get it and tore his leg.
Oh, okay. Yeah,
so that's how he went down. Denver Broncos in the playoffs, 11-2. They look nice. I don't know.
Still, I'm going with Seattle.
Going with Seattle?
I believe in Seattle.
Okay.
At home.
At home.
Seattle.
Okay. And NFC East, Eagles.
Eagles is the truth.
They the truth? 8-5. You think the boy can get it done?
They figure it out.
No more Michael Vick?
Vick, it's over.
It's over?
It's over, Vick.
So he can go to another team?
Nah, I don't think he can get to another team. I think he can end up somewhere like Tampa Bay, where he's just going to get a chance to play.
Yeah. And that's in the North. Detroit Lions, 7-6. Think they can make some noise? Reggie Bush running the ball in the backfield.
Can't play every game.
Johnson? Oh, okay.
Don't play every game.
In the South, New Orleans Saints, they look good against those Carolina Panthers. They look good at home. Stop Cam's run. They're 10-3. And in the West, those Seahawks, 11-2. They had a loss against those 49ers. That was a good game.
49ers is ready for
them. 49ers is ready for them. So you think they're ready to do it? No. Since they went to the Super Bowl last year.
No. Because they're going to do it on the road. They don't have no home games.
No home games. They're going to be on the road. Okay. Let's go to the NBA. Kobe Bryant.
You really want to go there?
Yes, we do.
He's back.
Nigga, I outplayed Kobe last night.
He's been off for 8 months.
He said
eight,
he fucked up.
8 months
said
in the week.
No, he didn't.
He came, said he was horrible.
He came back on today and said, I gave myself an F yesterday, but I looked at the tape. I was a D. No, nigga, you was an F. He was terrible.
Well, you know, his first game back. They had a great win the other night versus the Sacramento Queens.
Yeah, they did. Care. That comeback. Yes, it does.
You see that game?
Yeah, I did see it.
That was a great comeback. Kobe will be all right.
It's over for your boy.
Man, what's wrong with New York?
Oh, yeah, I believe that.
New York Knicks.
Man.
They need to get Carmelo over to the Lakers right now. Stop playing.
Somebody need to make a trade.
Because if y'all can lose by 40 with Carmelo. Dude.
At home to Boston.
Yeah.
Oof. And Boston threw their season in a long time ago. They ain't trying to win.
Right.
But Boston
like, nigga, why are you niggas winning?
Boston's leading the division.
What you trying to do?
Are they?
Yeah, they were leading the division. Shout out to Claudia Jordan, who's out on assignment.
Yeah, she's in Tokyo.
Yeah. And in baseball, Jay-Z got it going on with his group. Got that boy Robinson Cano, 10-year deal, 240. Big ones for the Seattle Mariners.
Right,
could
when
keep
he got
him in
that
New
deal,
York.
Me and Brooklyn went to the batting cage. I said, you finna learn this baseball shit.
No more soccer?
Okay, that's where the real money is, isn't it?
200 mil?
Real money.
Guaranteed. Which means, I don't care. That's why they mad at your boy Rodriguez.
Oh,
because
yeah.
They owe him 200, which is like 21, 22 million for the next 3 years.
Is he going to get it, you think?
Oh, yeah, he gets it. Million. But if they can get him on this thing where he's doing drugs, they don't have to pay him.
Right. Oh, okay. So they're going to chump up some charges.
They're trying.
And in golf, Zach Johnson took down Tiger Woods in your backyard, Speedy.
I couldn't get home.
Yeah.
It was traffic. I had to go around.
Yeah. What?
Fuck all you white people living in your area.
Yeah, it was a playoff
hole.
Boy hit a tremendous shot, Johnson. He hit it in the water, so he had to take a penalty.
That's his first win, right?
I don't know about his first win. First win over Tiger, I'll tell you that.
What is his tournament? So he can
but Tiger's still ranked number one in his tournament. So that's why I was crowded out this week. I wanted to call you and tell you to go the other way. And in college football, AFASU, Florida State University.
There you go.
Your boy Jameis Winston got dropped all the charges in his allegations, so he's still looking good for the Heisman Trophy.
So and they are really
do it. Ranked number one, I think. Number one for that BS. Bowl speed should be those guys versus the Auburn Tigers. What do you think about that?
Yeah, Auburn. Oof.
Would like to see Ohio State, but
that was a great game against Missouri, huh, too? Boy, through for all kind of records.
But I like Auburn. Auburn beat Alabama. I'm so happy.
Oh, wasn't that crazy?
That was a great game.
I actually watched that.
That game
was amazing.
I sat there and went, this motherfucker ran all the way. I'd have ran to my locker room.
Wait, after a bad punt.
I'd have ran to my locker room. You saw the one dude wants to sue.
What?
The fan from, because he said he stepped out of bounds.
He did
and
not.
He could prove it. And the fact that the referees didn't do it, he wants to sue.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
I don't think he stepped out.
Good for him.
It don't matter.
And that's Teeter Sports Ticker right here on Reach Around Radio. And shouts out to all Corn State.
Yeah. Oh,
and I wanted to mention, too, if my phone.
Yeah, your phone.
Dang, two.
Yeah, when you leave, you leave.
Oh, I was on the phone with 40. E40 just called me. He's about 20 minutes away, so he makes it in time.
10 minutes left of the show.
Because we're paying.
No, yeah.
Can't go.
We love you.
The thing in Philly that we were talking about earlier, I read a report that a police officer told a player on the team that when they lose.
No, you have to explain from the top.
The crime goes up.
When Philadelphia Eagles.
Shit. When the Philadelphia Eagles lose.
Your brother's here.
The crime rate
goes up.
We lost, bitch, give me some. Break yourself.
They say that their wins
and
losses dictate the mood and attitude of Philadelphia.
I believe it because the Lakers dictate mine.
Cam Marshall, call it and tell us what's going on with you. Thieving, losing.
Is it the white dudes? Gotta be the white dudes. Can't be the brothers.
No.
No, because once they'd have figured out the crime rate goes up, they'd have been waiting on that.
Michael Kendrick said this, whoever he is.
But you know what it is. It's like after your team wins, you know, you go out. You know, the Europeans always got reservations at the Olive Garden.
They were soccer
moves.
So Olive Garden.
I like the Olive Garden. Don't sleep. Don't sleep.
I know, right?
So, you know, you win, team, you feel happy with spending money. When your team lose, you eating all that, you be depressed. Like, I ain't paying for this. I'm out of here. Then I'm going to steal some shoes on the way home. So is that, it's all cities, but Philadelphia might be number one.
Well, I know that when Philly loses, Tashay's attitude is so stank.
Hey, Tashay.
Shout out to Tashay. What about Louis Dix? Does he get all?
Oh, yeah.
Mustache falls off.
You remember that time we were in the airport and Louis chest bumped a complete stranger with some other football team stuff on?
Oh, my God.
Louis is weird.
What Louis, I said, you're going to get your ass kicked.
But see, sports.
He just ran up to a dude out the blue in the airport and chest bumped him.
No, because see, with sports is that kind of camaraderie. Because he was wearing his Michael Vick jersey, so you know you see other guys in the airport wearing nice stuff. So Louis is very confrontational when it comes to sports. So I can't remember what city we were in, but this one dude, he had on the bomb Yankee jacket with all the championships on and everything. So Louis, you know, going up on this dude. He's like, you don't even have a baseball team. You don't even have a baseball team. He's like, so what? My Eagles. So, yeah, he chest bumping and all that. I'm like, wow. Louis, what are you doing? I said, you like that guy? You know, it's sports. I said, no, I think you like that guy. Louis too close.
Who was it, B. Scott?
Hilarious.
Shout out to B. Scott.
That was hilarious.
I told you the first time I saw him, it was weird. I was like, why that girl look like she had magic shade?
Why that girl got a 5 o'clock shade? It's Reach Around Radio. The phone lines are open 322-522-5482, and we'll be right back.
In the mix with DJ Always.
Yeah. 1, 2. What? Turn it on now. Is it on?
Yep.
Turn me up in headphones. It's Reach Around Radio.
You ain't a rapper.
Speedy is a rapper. You ain't got a CD?
What is it?
Two Chitlins on Garlic Powder Music.
It's Reach Around Radio. It's your boy, Speedy Doggy Dog in the house. Just want to say to all the beautiful ladies out there, get at your boy, because I know you want this thing.
What thing, Speedy?
Two Chitlins!
It's Speedy Doggy Dog.
I'm the POTUS.
Teeter on Twitter.
Nikki Pam.
She lost two fingers. Anyway. It's Club Fluffies.
And RT also texts. He says he's...
It's over for him. Anyway, it's Club Fluffies.
It's over, RT.
It's over.
Fuck it now.
It's White Night tonight. Come on in, white girls. Sisters, have a seat, because we're doing it like this.
Wow, sweetie.
Hey.
Sometimes I feel like I feel I've got to
eat some food.
Chew it now. From the pain you drive into
so far,
the
heart
of me, the love we
What are you doing, boy?
I know. I'm coming in the door, nigga.
Oh, it's me for me.
This nigga.
I got a show right going there. On.
Have a seat, man. He threw me off there, E.
Yeah.
You just busted in, Pippin. What's up, babe?
What's up, man?
Hi, 40.
What's up, man?
Big fan of him. You gotta be careful. He's a stalker.
Champ. Yeah, he is. He talking about he wants to sign
a stalker,
shit.
Yeah.
He took a bath today.
It's an E-40.
E-40, welcome to the show. It's uncensored. You can say whatever you want to say.
Whatever the
fuck you want to.
Oh, my bad.
Welcome.
Always like that.
Is this
Michael?
Oh, you know what?
Oh, no, we didn't do none of that.
No, we saw your interview. Wait a minute. You know what? I watched that interview with the Breakfast Club today, and I said I can tell you weren't really feeling that.
Yeah, I just didn't feel like going through. I ain't want to speak on all that stuff.
Yeah,
right. But I just want to clear the air a little bit on it, so I just clear the air or whatever.
But let's talk about my new album.
Else. Of course.
Let's do that.
Of course.
We're on the West Coast. Bitch. Bitch.
You got the new album coming out, The Block Brochure Part 4, 5, and 6.
Wow.
Three albums.
Yeah.
Wow. Why do you do it like that, 40?
It gave me room to cover all angles of the game, such as, you know, because I came in the game in 88. So with that being said, that gives me enough time to cover the old school music. I put a little bit of that in there, a little bit of mob music, you know what I mean? A little bit of, you know, today's, you know, a little bit of South, a little bit of, you understand me, ratchet music, you know what I mean? And I just take one budget and, you know, turn it into three albums.
So it's three albums with, what, 12 or 13 songs on each?
It's 15 songs on each.
Wow.
But each album got a skit. So it's really 14 full-length songs.
Mm.
Damn.
So that's
a lot of writing.
But that you always do that. Last year you did that too, right? Or earlier this year?
Yeah, I started, you know, I did a double CD in 1998.
Mm-hmm.
I did one in 97. That was the Southwest Riders. Me and B Legit put that out. You know what I mean? Then I did the Element of Surprise. That went gold. It's almost platinum. And that was a double CD on Jive. That was called the Element of Surprise. And then I had, in 2009, when I got a distribution deal with EMI, I decided to put two albums out the same day, separate.
So if both of them go platinum, that's two platinum albums.
Right. But you know, it's hard to go platinum nowadays without, you know.
Not you, they were stealing.
But
I can go ghetto platinum. That's right. 100,000 plus.
So really, 100,000 plus is like the...
That's really ghetto gold. I call it ghetto gold. When it's 100,000...
I remember it was 500,000 for gold,
That's certified gold. Yeah, but you know, I got four gold records and one platinum. And then I got a group of gold record. You know what I mean? But I'm just saying...
Which one was a gold song? I mean, a gold album.
Which one was a gold... Element of Surprise, Get a Report Card, Paula Gang, Paula Gang, Game Related,
Platinum
In a Major Way. That's the platinum. In a Major Way is the platinum one.
And what was the hit on that?
On the inner major way, sprinkle
boy. Sprinkle me, man. That's what I hear you say. Sprinkle me.
And I noticed that you have like a good mixture of guest appearances on your album as well. Like some of the new kids, some of the old players. So
that's right.
How important do you think it is that the older generation of hip hop collaborates with the younger generation?
You don't have to, but I rock with the youngsters. You know what I mean? Like I ain't ancient with my spit. You know what I mean?
White listeners, that means spit means when he go at him.
That's hilarious.
Or one or two.
White listeners more woke than you think nowadays.
Yeah. Shout out to Gabe who runs this place.
Right.
Gabe Timberlake.
But what was I saying? What was we at?
Relating with the younger generation.
Oh yeah. So you know, and it's a beautiful thing when you know you got a young 17, 18, 19-year-old like. Unk, I need you on this record, you know, and they know I'm in my 40s, but they know I'm a different type of 40-year-old, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
I'm gamed up, and I'm going to go hard when I spit, you know what I mean? So I'm locked in, and I appreciate it, I knock on wood, you know what I mean? But God's been good to me.
Okay. That's cool. I'm trying to set up this camera. Go ahead.
Trying to get you to stand.
Illegal shit right now.
40, we don't have it in our budget. We don't have a stand in our budget. She's trying to use the Icebreakers Frost.
Yeah. Well, see, here's what. You get these nice microphones, or we can get a stand.
Yeah.
We went with the microphone.
That's right. These some nice microphones.
So, I know that your son is producing Droopy.
Yeah.
And then I heard you mention that also Issue is also in the game. So what's some important advice that you tell them? This is your 25th year in hip-hop.
Yeah.
What do you tell your sons about the game?
If you want it, you got to go get it. Stay focused. Stay creative, which they are. Their music is way different.
Oh, man, Droopy's a beast. Yeah.
Droopy's a beast. Yeah. You know what I mean? And Issue, he a beast, too, in his own way, because he do different type of music. He do that international music like... He listened to like Pink Floyd and all kind of, you know.
Did he grow up listening to that with you being?
He just, you know, he these nowadays,
The internet, it gives you all kind of music now. You can just search, and there it is. So, you know, doing that over the years, he started making beats when he 11. He just turned 19. So, he on the case. You know what I mean?
That's right. My kids.
Yeah.
Feeling like a loser shit. Right about now? Son.
Droopy 25, you feel me?
Yeah, I'm 11.
Son, eating beats.
But I just tell him.
Hey, get shit together.
Nah, I just tell him to just stay focused, man. Just, you know, follow your dreams, man. It can come true.
Now, they asked you to be on the album, right?
Who, my son?
Your son.
Yeah. Exactly. Of course.
So,
hey, Dad, freak. Come on in.
I'm
going
to need you.
Exactly.
Just give me a sprinkle, me, Mike.
Now, we have the Earl Stevens Collection wine.
Great wine.
It is. I love the Moscato.
How you get that bottle? I'm just playing.
How I got this bottle is your lovely wife sent it to me.
Oh, that's
is this you? Yes. Yeah, that's mine. That's mine.
Wait. Who's Earl?
Well, it's hers now. It's y'all's now.
No, it's mine.
That's me. I'm Earl.
Yeah. So that's your real name?
That's my government name, yeah.
Shut up.
Earl Ford. Why did you decide to call it Earl Stevens?
I just wanted to do something elegant and, you know, and do something that they thought that I was not going to do.
Right.
You know, and, I figure, like I say, it's a Rodney Strong wine out there. It's a wine called Rodney Strong. It's one called Kendall Jackson. Why can't be Earl Stevens?
I like
you
it.
Feel
I
me?
Do too. It's a great name.
I'm putting people up on game.
I like how
Earl
it looks real.
No,
this is the
Earl
shit.
Stevens Moscato go great with Red Snapper.
That's right. That's
man,
right.
I'm telling you.
That's
he
right.
He got that mango scotto, too.
That, oh, I got that mango scotto. And I got a red blend.
That's the regular moscato. Oh. But he got the mango scotto.
Why do you know it's moscato?
We got to get some up to Fox.
We can't drink it now?
We need some.
No, because I want to save my...
That's our gift.
Hold on. No, so Earl said that's for the group.
Did you bring some bottles?
Nah, I didn't bring no bottles.
He didn't bring no bottles.
I'll get somebody in a couple days.
We can get it at what, any store?
Not yet.
Yeah, how do people get it?
We'll be able to in about 30 days.
Okay.
How can people get it now?
Right now online, EarlStevensSelections.com.
Okay, so now that you have a wine in your name, do you consider yourself a wine connoisseur?
Yeah, do you go to the winery?
I've always been that. Yeah, I was going to the winery when me and wifey was teenagers.
Okay.
Because it's right there in Napa.
Yeah, right there. 707, say it backwards. Can you say 707 backwards? You can say it backwards. Can you
707?
707.
I just said it.
That's my area code.
Thank you.
I was really trying to say it backwards.
We got the best weed in the world. That soil.
Yes, yes.
Humble County, Mendocino, all that. You know what I mean? That's Eureka. That's 707.
You ain't got no weed on you.
No, I don't.
He just got off the plane.
You know what I mean? And we got the best grapes. Oh. You feel me?
Right. Mm-hmm.
So what made you get into doing it?
I like wine, man. And I found the opportunity... ran across some people that can manufacture it and they real legit,
mm-hmm.
and just, you know, I always wanted to do, you know, wine. I'm gonna do a beer too, but I don't want to tell y'all the name of that. You want to know the name of my beer?
Yeah.
E40?
There you go.
Good job, Speedy.
Why would you change that?
And the slogan should be, it's burpalicious.
You stupid.
If you have a question for E40, the phone lines are open, 322-522-5482.
And for the punk that said the show was boring, sucks on punk.
Right.
Moving on. Go ahead.
Somebody said that?
Yeah,
somebody said it.
Why you listen? Why you listening?
We actually have two other co-hosts that aren't here tonight.
Yeah.
Yeah. So.
Good.
But they hostile and shit anyway. They always act like.
Yeah, our fans are hostile.
They're weird.
Some of them.
Sucks on punk.
I don't know, right?
TDP, you have some questions?
He got a whole cue card.
Could you tell us one of your favorite
hell of questions?
Oh, that was for my sports section.
Oh, my bad. Because
you're a 49ers fan, right?
You know that, buddy.
Yeah, I took a lot.
You seen us get down yesterday, man.
Yeah.
You see our record 9-4, man. Yeah.
So how do you feel?
Yeah, you know, we was in the Super Bowl last year. We didn't accomplish what we wanted to accomplish, but we did make it to the big
here's
dance.
Here's the problem, son.
We just tripped over our pants.
Mm. Here's the problem. Y'all have to win on the road. You're not going to be able to win them home games because you're not going to have any home games. Y'all going to be on the road.
But
you
got
to go to Seattle.
We mashing everybody.
No, not if you got to go to Seattle.
What, are you talking about in the playoffs?
Yes, sir.
Man, watch.
You think so?
Watch.
You believe in Kaepernick like that?
Yeah, because our confidence is up. We whooping on everything now. We got all our weapons back. Everybody back. Everybody. Ain't nobody sitting on the bench right now. Ain't nobody sick or hurt or whatever.
Okay. Yeah, but y'all going to be on the road.
It don't matter, man. You, okay. Well, who is your team?
Eagles. But look here, that's not what we're talking about.
You ain't gonna let it do it, no.
You know what I'm saying, Earl? You need to stay focused.
We talk about the Niners,
we're talking about the Niners.
Right. Hey, let me tell y'all something about Twitter, man. It's a trip. I might put, I'll put Niners, man. I'll put it on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. You get people that just, Raider Nation, you bitch.
On Twitter.
I'm like, man, I'm like, why y'all act like I'm talking to y'all? I'm just saying Niners, right, man. Right. You know what I mean? They get, right, fuck the whiners, woo, woo, woo. It's like, man, I'll never say nothing about the Raiders because that's our backyard. That's the Bay.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. I ain't got nothing to see. I like the Raiders as well and the Niners, but I know that I got to roll with one team.
Right.
And I'm rocking with the 49ers. Though.
I grew up
in Vallejo. See, we don't have no football team. Now, nah, Vallejo is 20, 30 minutes from Oakland.
I've been to Vallejo.
Yeah.
It's right off that. What's that freeway?
But it's, so, but it's not.
See,
but
see, you got,
look, San, like the 49ers, the San Francisco 49ers is in San Francisco.
Okay.
The Oakland Raiders is in Oakland.
And Vallejo.
Vallejo
is,
has Corbis Field, which is where the high school players play.
Okay.
So I'm saying we don't have a football team.
So how'd you become a 49er fan and not Oakland fan?
I liked the Oakland fan back when Jim Plunkett was playing and Dave Casper and Lyle Alzado and Art Shell and all them. You know what I mean? So I was a kid. So okay. I liked Dallas Cowboys. My cousin used to play for the Dallas Cowboys, Dennis Thurman, number 32, free safety, way back in the day.
Yes, sir. It was nice.
You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. It was nice.
So basically all I'm saying is all my folks, they was like, man, you got to pick a side. Because it was times I did go to the Raider games and the 49ers games because all my neighbors, Merton Hanks, you understand me, he was 49er. You know what I mean? Chester McLaughlin, he was a Raider.
Yeah.
You understand me? Ricky Waters, he was a Raider. You understand me? Dennis Doublefield, he was a 49er. These are all my neighbors. Nah, this is all my newer neighborhood. Where, you know,
Where the wine is.
Upper step.
Where Earl is.
Yeah, exactly. Where Earl is.
That's where you got the house with the gate already there.
There you go.
Well, we have some phone
It was a
calls.
Gate before I came in there. Right. I had to build that thing.
Yes,
go ahead.
Caller, what's your name and from where are you calling?
Punk.
What's good? It's Jay Nasty.
Hey, Jay Nasty.
You got something for E?
What it do? Yo, E-40, what's good, homie?
What's up with you?
Chilly chill, man. Hey, I just want to say I respect what you do.
Right.
As a lyrical artist and always staying true to your roots and what you actually do out here, because mad niggas sit there and switch over. You got love. You get mad love from New York all the way down to Atlanta, my nigga, on the East Coast.
Right on, man. Thank you, man. Game recognized, game real recognized, real, Brad.
Yes, sir. But everybody else, I just want to say what's up. I haven't talked to y'all forever, except for OG. OG be repping on the hangouts with us, so that's what's up.
Hey, did you text me?
Your
number? Did you text me?
Damn, you just give your nigga number?
Oh. I text you earlier. I text you earlier to see how you was doing.
Okay.
Wow. What the fuck is going on?
Hey, Cam, I've been hanging out on the Google Hangout with our fans. Have you seen Jay Nasty?
Uh-uh.
He's actually cute, but he's crazy.
Oh, word? Oh, you crazy?
Because
he's high school?
He's cute, but he's crazy.
I'm sorry you had to deal with this right now. Apparently, we're in the seventh grade.
Hey, no personal calls.
Thank you.
Good luck.
Thank you, Jay.
Right
on, Jay.
You got another call? Okay. So.
I got a question.
Go ahead.
So, I'm from L.A. First time I heard about you was through my boy TDP over there. How'd you get that lingo? How'd you get the sprinkle me, man?
When I was young, I used to make up long words, just create, not make them up, but just, you know, just try to say long words, always in the dictionary and just joking around and stuff. And then being in the Bay Area, you know, I ain't the only one who got a slick mouthpiece.
Right.
You know, it's embroidered in me, the surroundings.
Okay.
This is it's the Bay Way. It's the Bay Way.
They got to play my cut. Always, you got to play.
I want money on the floor.
What's the one here?
No, he
too
like,
short nose. I get on his nerves all the time.
Yeah. I want to hear. Don't go back to slinging. Yeah.
Now, did you have to pay
for that?
What? Don't go back to. Yeah.
Like major money?
No. Earth Wind and Fire. That's cool, man. That was Earth Wind and Fire. Ramsey Lewis. But they, you know, but you know, of course we had to, back in them days, samples was, you know, everybody was sampling. Mm-hmm. But
so they came and saw you late.
But we had to pay on the publishing side because there was a playover.
Okay.
So Aunt Banks played it to a T. He played it good. And then we had Otis and Suge singing on the hook. They sound so professional.
some of the Raw singers. But, of course, you know, I had to pay everybody that participated.
Gotcha.
You know what I mean? But Earth, Wind & Fire, I used about three or four of their songs before.
This is
that's my favorite group in the world.
Mine too.
As far as soul, R&B, you know what I mean? You too?
You've worked with a lot of artists. Really? Who haven't you worked with yet, and who do you want to work with?
There's a lot of people I haven't worked with yet. I want to work with Dr. Dre if that ever happened.
What?
Really? You haven't?
We West Coast, and you know, I grew up on Dr. Right. Dre. You
know,
no,
I'm saying, I'm surprised that you guys have not worked together.
Right.
All right, Dre is out there. Get it, Earl.
I want to work with Jay-Z. I want to work with Nas.
Yes.
You know what I mean?
That'd be a great collab, all right.
Now, things like that, do you reach out to them, or you kind of wait to see if they're going to hit you? Or?
I reach out. I don't have no pride problem or anything like that.
So if you have a song, you say, such and such will sound good on this, let me call them or whatever.
Get the right tracks together, you know, see what it do.
So what's your favorite collaboration that you've done so far? I mean, you know what mine is. Ooh. Obviously Too Short.
Yeah. Right. Yeah, Short got a bunch of them things.
I love Short.
My favorite collaboration is with The Click. It was Be Legit, Sugar T, and D-Shot, the earlier days.
Yes.
And, you know, me and Be Legit, you know, we, you know, our chemistry is... It's just automatic.
Right.
You know what I mean? And also the Too Short work, you know, doing work with Too Short, you know, that's like me and Be Legit. You know what I mean?
So when will there ever be another Click album?
I think so. Mm-hmm. I think we need to go ahead and do that just for the energy. Be Legit, one of the best rappers in the game ever.
Man. We have another call.
Caller, what's your name and where you calling from?
Punk.
Hey, what's happening, y'all? It's Wayne Wizzle.
Hey, Wayne Wizzle.
Yeah,
what's good? Yeah.
Hey, these people crazy.
That other shit
here.
To do, man. You see us talking to E, you keep calling in. Nigga, what you want?
Hey, that's his favorite.
That's who I call to talk to. I wanted to say what's up with y'all, too, but you know what I'm saying? I want to holler at 40.
What's up, Wayne Wizzle?
What's up, man? Hey, listen, man.
I
just want to let you know.
He didn't fake it.
I might be your biggest fan out here in L.A., man.
You think so?
I've been repping since day one.
Which one? Because it's been a long time, Jack.
Yeah, which
get
album?
It right. Go
my
get
first, my
yeah,
first
it's been
album.
A long
my
time, first in a major way.
Okay.
Federal.
But you know, that was a long time ago.
Every album since then. Every one of them.
Okay, that's being honest. Okay. That's 18 years right there, going on 19. Yeah, that's 18 years for show, for show. That's pretty good right there. Now, let me ask you this. Are you prepared to go to your iTunes thing and order, Demi E40, the block brochure 4, 5, or 6 tonight at 9 o'clock California time? You feel me?
West Coast time.
West Coast. Or are you prepared to go to the store tomorrow, Best Buy or FYE or something like that, or your neighborhood local mom and pop store, and snatch them 3 CDs up? Are you prepared for that? Do you know about that?
You goddamn right. I'm going tomorrow.
Wayne Wizzle, please download him.
Goddamn right.
No, man, don't download him.
No, because see, Wayne Wizzle played on our softball team and he dropped every ball, so I don't want him to drop your CD.
But when you say download, we go to iTunes.
Right. Go to iTunes.
Are you still pretty much independent?
Yeah, I am independent.
Yeah, so 100%. It's important that you guys.
So all that money
go
to you.
That's
the distributor.
Right.
The whole $10.95?
And the distributor and the retailer.
That's how it is.
Because he want to be a rapper.
How much you get? $8.95?
Yeah. Okay.
You got to break bread with, you know, you got to break bread with people, man.
Yeah. That's right.
You know?
Hey, I'm not still on.
I get a nice chunk, though.
Six something.
Nice
six,
chunk
six,
out
more
of
more than you would if you were signed to
a
definitely more than I would if I was signed to a major label.
Yeah.
Hell yeah.
Definitely, by far.
I need to borrow $10 for parking.
I got you for sure.
Hey, y'all.
So, Wayne, you have any other questions for 40?
Wizzle?
Hey, no, I just wanted to say, Foley, keep making that music for the West Coast. Keep representing. I hope you don't stop. You always got a faithful fan in me. You know what I'm saying?
Yes,
every
sir.
Time.
Thank you, brother.
A little soft.
This is the first time these niggas called up here and acted like they got some sense.
Well, I appreciate that, Wayne Wizzle.
Right.
Yeah, no, they come
so
here.
So, 40, when you are, I mean, because you write a lot of songs. Mm-hmm. I mean,
stay in the studio,
I mean,
obviously.
That's 45 songs.
No,
here's my question.
Where were you when you said, I'm going to make this
a hit right here. Make this nigga take care of your kids.
Make that nigga make call your kids. He is make that nigga get out there and work. Make his ass buy you a duty and birth.
It's the whole point of that nigga take care.
See, what nigga come save me? Where were you at when you came home?
You at the mall.
Nah, it's just that's what motherfuckers be doing. They be saving hoes. The thing is, it's okay to save your female if it's your real, like your main squeeze, right. Your real girlfriend. But when you saving, like when you're tricking and with the other bitches on the stuff, and you really break paper on them, you're a captain save a hoe.
Okay.
When you know what I'm
you
saying?
You do what? Paper what?
When you break, you know, breaking them off with, you know,
okay, cool.
Shooting them. Shooting them.
I'm writing this shit down.
Like, you don't know nothing about that, Huspeedy, breaking them off.
I can't give no money.
Rest haven, man. There's a lot of rest havens, man. Captain Saver hoes out there, man. Rescue Ronnie's, you know what I'm saying?
Rescue Ronnie's.
You like that one, girl?
Rescue Ronnie. And how you spell Ronnie? With two I's or I?
However you want to spell it.
Look at what a W's at.
Low G in that motherfucker somewhere.
Rescue. Nigga.
We was at Studio Talks when we made the song. We was all together and knocked that shit out. As soon as we left the studio, you know, Cousin Caviar was like, cuz, this one of them ones.
Yeah.
As soon as we walked out the door, he just, man, this one of them ones for sure. Yeah.
So I was saying, 40, you got like, shit, 45 songs coming out tomorrow.
Yeah.
Or nine. What's the average that you write songs? Like two a day, three a day? I mean, how fast do you kick out a song?
I peck at it. Like, I might do a verse right here and then go back to another song like 2 days later and come back to that one.
Mm-hmm.
You know
mm-hmm.
what I mean? Mm-hmm. Like, I just peck at it, you know what I mean? Like that. So that's how I do it. And then, because I want all my verses to be right.
Right.
You feel me? And just being in the studio consistently.
Would you say you're in the studio what? 80% of the time, touring 20. Or
when I'm working on the albums, definitely about it. Like, I ain't been in the studio, like, actually doing music in probably about a month and a half. That's not like me. I'm normally right back in there, but I got to take a break. I'm tired.
Yeah,
now.
I mean,
right.
That's astonishing. Because Tupac did that a lot too, right? You worked with Pac. How was your relationship with Tupac?
Oh, gravity. You know what I mean?
That means good, y'all.
Yeah.
White folks are
Tupac,
the one.
Tupac was, if he like you, he love you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know, he don't like phony motherfuckers. He just didn't.
Right. Right.
He don't like fake people.
Yeah.
He spoke his mind.
Mm-hmm.
Sound like poetess.
And you asked, I remember one time, MTV, I think it was MTV or somebody, they was interviewing him, and it was an interview, and they was like, so it was a real up close and personal intimate type of
setting,
you know, setting. And they was like, so Tupac, so what do you think, you know, gets you in trouble the most? He just, my big fat mouth, because he speak his mind.
Right.
You remember that?
Yeah.
I remember that.
You know, but he spoke his mind, man. And
he wrote like pretty much like you did. I mean, he was always writing songs.
He would have, but I'm doing these three, he'll probably have six of them. He'd be dropping six of them. That's just how, because he was quicker. But, you know, because the way I rap fast. So it's a lot of words being said. So that's really, like in one verse might be three verses for the average person. You know what I mean?
Exactly.
So it ain't that easy for me.
You write them down.
I got a question for you.
Write them down?
Yeah, I write them down sometimes. Sometimes I sit here right here and just, you know what I mean? I ain't no freestyler or nothing. But,
I was going to ask you that.
You know what I mean? Yeah, these suckers be trying to act hard.
Mm.
But they don't know that I pulled a hoe card.
Mm.
You understand me? I'm out here, you understand me, doing fine. Yeah. About to get on some of that Earl Stevens wine. You know what I mean?
Awesome.
So you don't really
battle. Yeah, I just go in there and just punch in. Like, punch
now, what if somebody went at you, though?
Yeah, like a Captain Ryan over here.
I'm raw. Motherfucker don't want to make no diss songs about me, because when I go in, I go in.
Mm-hmm.
When I go in and I'm funny, too, I had your ass crack it up with
That's
it.
Right.
I make motherfucker feel real puny.
Yeah,
don't make no diss. You got to be on my level, though. I ain't just finna just, you know, make no diss. I mean, respond to nothing, no a motherfucker.
Yeah, to a dude that hot dog on a stick.
Yeah, I ain't finna, because motherfuckers try to make, people have made diss records and shit just to try to get me to respond or something. Just because they just, you know, motherfuckers do anything, man.
Right.
But anyway, I shoot that to the left and don't pay attention to let it just.
So you, all know, you rescue Ronnie's out there.
Yeah.
I love that motherfucker, you rescue Ronnie.
But now Pac was, man, he was it, man. He was it. He used to do like 9 songs a day. And I was and 4 at the least.
That's how Prince used to do.
Wow.
God damn, that's a hell of a jump right there.
It's Reach Around Radio. The phones are open. 322.
You know, George Carlin used to do a lot of that.
5482. We're going to take a quick break, and we'll be right back.
Shout out to Rescue Ronnie. Kill yourself. Your baby mama love me. Your baby daddy hate me. Yeah, who's this?
Your bitch wanna
fuck me. Oh, shit. I said your bitch wanna fuck me. It's Reach Around Radio.
Chitty Bang Bang.
I just want to let all the ladies know out there.
Chitty Bang Bang.
I'm going to throw this out to all the ladies out there. I ain't no Rescue Ronnie. So you got to get at me right. You know what I'm saying? I'm a real nigga out here. You know what I'm saying? I'm out here getting this pizza paper like I'm supposed to be doing. You know what I'm saying? Take over for me. Take over for me, E.
I'm going to back up.
Yeah. E-40's in the building.
That's right. It's Reach Around Radio. The phone line's 322-522-5482. The white boy is in the building.
Hey, what is up, y'all?
He made it.
Why is the white guy late? What's up with that?
I know.
Do you go by the white boy?
I'm RT. That's probably my nickname, pseudo nickname.
Okay.
The white boy.
RT.
RT. Okay.
I see.
I'm RT 40. You smell me.
Forty. I don't know if you remember this. A long time ago, we were in. I think it was your hotel room. Mm-hmm. What story are you about to tell? Richie Rich. It was a whole gang of us.
Yeah.
And that's when I was rapping back then, and I rapped for y'all, and you was like, you sound East Coast.
That sounds just like me. I say some shit like that.
Def Jeff was my mentor.
Right,
so.
Def Jeff was raw.
Yeah. Her mentor.
But you, I remember you rapped. Was you on Delicious Vinyl?
No, I was on Interscope.
Interscope.
Yep, but I was on Interscope.
Now, who was the girls on Delicious Vinyl?
Body and Soul.
Exactly.
D Barnes and Rose.
Exactly.
MIT, yep.
That's heavy.
Yep.
I remember I was on Jamie Foxx show with you. Remember that when I was on the show?
Yeah.
I didn't want that not to be said.
It was the last episode. Yeah. It was the last episode. When,
of the Jamie Foxx TV show or radio show?
The TV show.
Oh,
I did like 10 of them.
Yeah, he was on there for sure.
Was he the security guard?
Yeah.
He was the...
Radio show?
The TV show.
Oh, yeah, I did like 10 of them.
Yeah, he was on there for sure.
Was he the security guard?
Yeah.
He was the...
Hey, craft services, get over here.
Yeah, he was.
I was pleased.
He was on craft services. What's homegirl name that he married on the show?
Francesca.
What do we call her? What they call
it? Fancy.
Fancy. Okay, so remember you gave Fancy the ring. They was like, they have the ring, and you gave him the ring.
Yeah, I had a few lines here.
Was it an onion ring?
Yeah.
Wedding ring, man. Yeah, wedding ring.
Yeah, that's what he said.
We have a call. Caller, what's your name, and from where are you calling?
Punk.
Hey, what's happening, y'all? This is Corey motherfucking Austin.
Hey, Corey motherfucking Austin.
How you living, son?
What's happening? I'm living good. 40, what's happening tonight? I've been a fan of yours for a minute.
What's up with you, pimp?
Been a fan of yours for a minute. Hey, my favorite song by you is "Happy to Be Here." Where did that concept come from?
I'm just happy to be here. Can I tell you a story about that real quick?
Yeah. Oh yeah.
So, first of all, you know them are the kind of songs I like to do, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I try to put myself. Right. I'm the narrator. I'm the hood commentator. You know what I'm saying? So I try to talk for the people.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? So. With that being said, that was on my Ghetto Report Card album, right?
Mm-hmm.
Right. That's the one, the songs that was on the Ghetto Report Card was You and That Booty, Tell Me When to Go, songs like that, Go Hard or Go Home, you feel me? I got to tell y'all, that went gold, too. That went gold.
Yes, yeah. That was 500,000.
Certified, yeah. Over 500,000, you feel me?
But money went on to his pocket. That was all your money went to your pocket.
Yeah, okay. A little bit.
Can I write down some of your slang?
I'm already doing it. So look, check this out. Let me tell you something real funny. So, you know, Lil Jon, he the king of crunk. You know, he love party music, right?
Yeah.
So, you know, I say, Lil Jon, man, I got to put this record on my album. He say, don't nobody want to hear no sad songs. Right? Right. So I say, man, I got to do it, right? So it was bothering me, right? Because, you know, I let him A&R the thing. I was up under their label, BME. Right. That's my guy to this day.
Right.
So I go to Vince over at BME. You know what I mean? I say, Vince, man, God telling me to put this song on my album. I got to, I don't never Who? Not put no God, G-O-D.
Wow.
You know God?
Huh? I love God.
Okay, I didn't know you or Earl knew God.
E-40 and Earl know
okay,
God.
My bad.
You know what I mean? So I was like, I do this on all my albums. I got to do it. And so Vince was like, well, if God telling you to put it on there, you better put it on there. Mm. He so
Next thing you know, we over Tom Wiley house, and Lil John had came in. It was like a big gathering. He was just, "What's up, nigga?" He said, "Yeah, I just got finished mastering the album. I put all the up-tempos in the front and the slower ones in the back, and I put your sad song on."
I almost listened to sad.
So look, you familiar with the Source Hip Hop quotables back in them days, right? Mm-hmm. So that was my first time ever having a Source Hip Hop quotable out of all them years was from that song, "Happy to Be Here," bruh.
Wow.
Wow.
That was a story.
Yeah.
So I just wanted to shoot that, share that with you since you brought this song up.
No doubt. I appreciate that, man. What's up, OG Poetess?
What's up, Corey? Now, the question is, are you going to go cop that block brochure part 4, 5, and 6?
At 9 o'clock. Tonight at 9 p.m. 12 Eastern.
My music collection wouldn't even be a collection without it.
Right on, folks.
Great answer.
Right on, man.
Pick that up.
No doubt.
I appreciate you. Thank you for calling in, man. Continue supporting Voting Water, man. Much love. Thank you.
No problem. Appreciate it.
Get the liquor, too.
Again, tell us the block brochure 4, 5, and 6 drops tonight at 9 o'clock here on the West Coast.
Oh, wow.
Midnight
on iTunes.
The East Coast, iTunes. And it's also available in Best Buy.
Tomorrow, the official day it comes out. Best Buy, FYE. Mm-hmm. You understand me? Get all three, man. They slaps.
What's FYE?
FYE.
It's a record store.
It's record store retailer.
Okay. Rescue Ronnie. And
then you got to pop this.
Showboat Shamar.
Speedy, it's also available at D&D, Dunkin' Donuts. You can also buy it there.
And also you can get the Earl Stevens collection. You can go online, too.
Yeah,
right?
It's available. Go to EarlStevensSelections.com, and I got Moscato, that's 11% alcohol, and then I got Mango Moscato, which I call it Mango Scotto, and that's 18% alcohol, feel me? And it's going, and it tastes hella good.
Yes.
Yes, Demi.
It's sweet with a kick.
And it'll be in stores in a month. And check this out. And also, I got a rare blend that's Zinfandel and Cabernet mixed together with like an oak flavor, and it's just perfect on the palate.
I gave that bottle to Bishop Don Juan.
What? Oh, yeah, I see the picture. I think I tweeted that. Yeah. Happy belated birthday to Bishop Don Juan, man.
I got an idea. Work with me, Weeples. Feel me out here, Pippin.
Okay, talk to me. I talk black.
Yeah, I'm talking to E, not Earl. Look here. We could use a sponsor on this show. We would love to have this liquor as our sponsor, man. That would be dope. You know?
Hey, and I would love to do it. Once I get this thing all the way up and running, once the Gouda get the circulating, it's only 4 weeks into it, like 4.5 weeks into it, so I'm a baby in this.
Right.
But I guarantee you it's going to be something. I'm hoping. I'm knock on wood. I'm hoping this thing blow. It's looking good.
From
right
our
now.
Listeners alone, it's going to blow up.
Right on. That's what I'm talking about.
And y'all be looking out for that beer coming, too.
Yeah, the 40.
The 40 coming?
Hold it, wow.
March. Like March.
Okay. And is it going to be a 40? That'd be dope.
You know it is.
Remember the slogan. Come in.
Remember the slogan. It's Burpalicious.
Well, 40, thank you for
where you going?
For blessing us. Thank you for letting me come here and promote my stuff. And it's always good to see you, POTUS, and everybody in here.
Hey, can I just tell an E-40 story real quick? I'm from the South. I'm from Atlanta. So, you know, we talk funny, too. But y'all talk funny on the West Coast. Hella funny.
Or is it just me? I think I'm the only one.
But so, listen, when we first heard your shit in the South, dude, me and my crew, we were laughing at you. We were laughing at you because, like, how he talks. Because nobody really talked like that, right? So we were the first person to hear that somebody talk like that. And then the more we listened to it, we were like, this shit is dope. It is off the chain.
You know,
ever since then, I've been having respect for West Coast stuff. So I just want to
thank you, man. That a lot of people, when you first came out, had that same.
Didn't know what to think. I didn't know what to make of it. Nobody knew.
They didn't know.
A lot of people, they was like, I thought that nigga was whack. But now they fucking love you. They're like.
Yeah, that's true.
So they weren't used to hearing that. Their ear wasn't trained.
Yeah, it wasn't. And it was something different, you know, unorthodox rap style.
Yep.
Start, stop, and go scoot type delivery with hella game involved. Start, stop, and go scoot type delivery with hella game involved, though.
You need to do
never explain yourself to a rescue run.
Forty, you need to do a book on tape series of like nursery rhymes for kids where you just spit it how you spit it. That'd be great.
That'd be
great.
That would be dope.
Yeah, nursery rhyme according to E-40.
According to E-40.
So again, the block brochure.
Go get it, sure.
4, 5, and 6. In stores tonight,
on iTunes tonight. In stores tomorrow, and I'll be signing autographs at the FYE on Torrance.
Oh, nice. Tomorrow?
Uh-oh. Tomorrow at 6 p.m., 6 to 8.
I'm sure come out there. Wayne Wilson will be there.
Yeah, Wayne will be there.
Wayne Wilson.
Yeah, y'all come on out,
FYE
Wayne.
FYE in Torrance. Nice.
Yes, yep. Yeah, I'll be here. Right out here in Southern California.
We want to remind our fans to please subscribe to our YouTube channel.
Please.
Plus, go get that app. You can go to our website, reacharoundradio.com. We got the app icon. Just click it and order our RAR wrap. And don't forget, once again, our YouTube channel. We're trying to get those subscriptions up. Yeah. You can follow me on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook at OG Poets.
Keep saying that. Yo, it's your boy Speed Doggy Dog. I just want to let all the ladies know I do got that slow shit on my album. Get at your boy.
Two chickens!
It's on Instagram, it's Speedy is Funny. That's Speedy IZ Funny.
Impossible.
Friday, I'll be in Palm Springs. And on the 20th.
Yeah, you ain't taking off.
Is DJ always going?
No, you can't do
that. You staying at another hotel. Our DJ got banned from a hotel in Palm Springs.
A little bit too much drink. But look at it. And I'll be in Seattle, Washington. Be in Seattle on the 29th. So come on out to that show in Seattle. If you're in Seattle, come on out. That's all on my Facebook page. E is on you.
You can check out all the social media, E40. That's twitter.com/E40, Instagram, E40, just E40, that's it. My Facebook is just facebook.com/E40, you feel me? I probably got about a million some likes on Facebook.
Nice.
So subscribe.
Only about 400,000 Twitter fans, but that's because I was hard-headed and real stubborn. I mean, not fans, but followers. Right. I was hard-headed and stubborn when Warner Brothers tried to get me to get on Twitter in 08, and I was just like real OG-ish and stubborn. And then I found out I had to adjust to it, and like I rock with it. You got to do it.
Yeah. Man,
I probably would have been up to a meal ticket or two by now, you feel me? As far as with the followers. But then I got Instagram, you feel me? So y'all check me out, man. I'm on there real active. You feel me? Hello, hello.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
The block brochure 4, 5, and 6. Yes, Tammy. Available on iTunes tonight at 9 o'clock. Is this Pacific time?
Yeah, yes, sir.
Pacific time, you feel me? And then tomorrow, go to FYE, or Best Buy. Go to Best Buy, any of them. I'll be at FYE out here in L.A. on Torrance. Torrance and so what's the other street, the cross street?
Hawthorne?
That'll be Hawthorne.
Sopa,
La Brea.
Sepulveda.
There you go.
Hawthorne and Sepulveda then.
There you go.
Yes, that's what it is.
Yeah, that's what I'm going to be.
Okay, Peter.
TDP, Mr. 123 Knox Baby. That's Facebook and Twitter. Holla at your boy. Thanks, everybody. And make sure you support our page, our YouTube channel. That's Reach Around Radio on YouTube. And make sure you download our app, which is on iTunes as well, right after you download E40.
There we go.
On iTunes.
Can I come back in real quick?
Yeah, for sure. Yeah.
Oh, don't forget to go online and purchase Earl Stevens Selections Mango Scotto, or my regular Moscato with 11% alcohol, and then the Mango Scotto got 18% alcohol, and then the Red Blend Function. It's called Function Red Blend. That's 13% alcohol. You feel me? Go to EarlStevensSelections.com.
Hello. And it goes great with fish.
And it go good with steak. You know, a nice little, you know what I mean, filet mignon, next, butterfly, Oscar style. You feel me? Okay, go ahead.
Next, you got to do the weed blend. The green weed blend wine. The cannabis blend. You can look me up on Twitter at RT Steckel, and Facebook, what? YouTube, RT Steckel Comedy, to look at some funny shit.
Now.
And Nikki Pam on Twitter and Instagram, 2Ks, and Facebook, Pam Nikki Baker.
Also, I got to send a few birthday shout-outs. Sorry we don't have time to do the sexy shout-out, but we'll say a happy birthday to Will McCray.
Hey, Will.
To Shaw.
Hey, Shaw.
To Kiara.
Hey, Kiara.
Haji. And Antonio Phillips and Patrick Coates.
There we go.
Okay, so
happy birthday to Team RAR members, and happy birthday. You going to do the sexy shout-out for Pam's birthday?
Do we have time?
I got you.
Cue the music.
Yeah, cue the music.
She said she wanted a three-way.
Hold on, boy. Watch your tone.
Threesome.
Oh, she wanted a three-way?
Yeah,
she
wanted one.
So get in there, RT. Your heart is crazy, man.
I just want to say,
coming from Rescue Pam. Ronnie.
Hey, Pam, whatever you may need, whatever you might want, I'll take care of that for you, baby.
Sneechy put this thing in your mouth for your birthday. You blow on that motherfucker and you come get something. So I'll bring it over here tonight for you to blow on that. Blow that candle out there.
That ain't a fucking sexy shot.
That's a sexy flip. Like,
that's rape.
She's like, excuse me. That's my Jameson. That's my Jameson.
Excuse me. Excuse me.
Uh-oh. Thanks, you guys.
Hold up now.
Oh, shit.
Watch Nikki mouth. Pam, now that you had your appetizer over there with Rescue Ronnie, it's time for this main course.
Main course.
Lay down and take this horse.
I've seen the horse.
That thing's got an elbow on it.
Y'all and crazy.
And I'm going to put it in you by force. Happy birthday, force Nikki Pam,
thank
a.k.a.
you.
Scrambled Eggs.
Love you guys. Okay.
And happy birthday, Nikki Pam.
Oh, look at the whiteboard.
Whenever you need that couch clean, let me know. I can clean that motherfucker out for you.
Okay.
Happy birthday.
Is that your Elvis voice?
I mentioned earlier, real quick, that I had a dream about you. Oh.
Sexual. Oh. That you hit.
Sexual. Sexual dream?
You hit. You hit.
Can you tell it real quick?
Yes, I did it.
You hit.
Oh, wow.
No, he didn't hit in the dream. We just kissed, and I remember looking for a condom, and that was it.
That will fuck the moment up, too.
Yeah, I think that part.
As soon as he goes, you got a condom.
God damn.
Dude, here we go.
We'll catch you guys next time. Follow us on Twitter at RAROfficial1 to find out when the next show is. We out.
Happy birthday, everyone.
It's just the tip.